गुड मॉर्निंग लर्नर्स, आज हम MAED 207 मेजरमेंट एंड इवेल्युएशन अर्थात मापन एवं मूल्यांकन का अध्ययन करेंगे। इवेल्युएशन प्रोसेस एसर्टेन्स द वर्कएबिलिटी ऑफ लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड चेंज इन बिहेवियर ऑफ द स्टूडेंट और लर्नर। इवेल्युएशन इज मोर कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव कंसेप्ट ऑफ मेजरमेंट इन वर्ड्स ऑफ राइट स्टोन। According to Bradfield, evaluation is an assignment of symbols to a phenomenon in order to characterize the worth or value of phenomenon, usually with reference to some social, cultural, and scientific standard. The cognitive, affective, and psychomotor learning outcomes are measured in the evaluation process. Evaluation approach improves the instructional procedure. This step provides an empirical basis to modify and improve the teaching learning situation. There are three main functions of evaluation. Evaluation of learning system, measuring learning outcomes, managing by learning objectives. A teacher can turn his teaching into successful teaching with the knowledge and application of these functions. There are two distinct situations where the evaluation is being used in relation to education. The two distinct situations are evaluation in an educational program and evaluation of an educational program. The question of the extent or quality of education achieved covers by evaluation in an educational program, and the concern of evaluation of educational program is more with the process product relationship in achieving desired product. Now we look at concept of measurement and evaluation. Measurement is a part of the process of evaluation when we assign a score on a given task performed by learner. We are doing an act of measurement. When we compare this score with those of other learners, whether it is good, bad, or average, we are doing the act of evaluation. The evaluation is more wider and inclusive term than measurement. Now we look at purpose and functions of evaluation. The first purpose of evaluation is diagnosis. This is the purpose of evaluation when it is used to help us locate and identify the weaknesses in learning on the part of learner. This might help us in producing suitable remedial courses for a given group of learner. Second is prediction. This is the purpose when evaluation help us discover potential abilities and aptitudes among the testees, which eventually can be developed into expertise in a given field of learning. Third one is selection. This will be the purpose of evaluation when it helps us select suitable person for a course. The entrance test of different courses are devised with this purpose. And fourth is grading and counseling. This is the purpose of evaluation when it assist the person in making decision about courses and career. This purpose of guidance is served when evaluation enables a learner to know his pace of learning. The self-assessment exercises in distance education material are meant to serve this purpose. Now we look at classification of evaluation technique. All techniques of evaluation can be broadly classified into two categories: quantitative technique of evaluation and qualitative techniques of evaluation. The quantitative techniques are mainly used in educational evaluation. These are highly reliable and valid. They possess all three characteristics and can be classified into three types: oral, written, and practical. Oral technique of evaluation are used at lower level in organizing and leading teaching activities. The oral questions, debate, and drama are used for this purpose. Written technique. In this type, the written questions are asked and the students have to write their answer. The written tests are more effective than oral. Written tests are usually of two types: essay type and objective type. Practical techniques. In this type of evaluation, some work is assigned to the student to accomplish it. Such techniques are based to assess the skill or psychomotor objectives. This technique is used in science, geography, home science, agriculture, etc. Now we look at qualitative techniques of evaluation. The qualitative techniques are used in schools and colleges for internal assessment. The first is cumulative record. Such records are prepared in a school for each student. The cumulative record of a student includes the educational progress, result of monthly, half-yearly tests, attendance, participation in games, sports, co-curricular activities, and physical health. The cumulative record of a student provides the awareness about their progress and weakness of parents, teachers, and principal. Second is anecdotal record. This type of record maintains the description of significant event and work or performance of the student. A merit list is prepared in schools. The correct information is obtained regarding incident and performance of a student in anecdotal record. The interest and learning of a student can be assessed with the help of such record. Such record can also be used to provide the guidance to the student. Next is checklist. The technique is used for evaluating interest, attitude, and values of a student. It includes certain statement of yes and no type. The student has to check either of the two. Another is rating scale. The rating technique is used for assessing the attitude of a student towards teaching and subject. It consists of some statement which can be rated on 3, 5, 7 point scale. It is used for higher classes because it requires the power of judgment of a student. A teacher can make use of this technique for evaluating the effectiveness of this instructional process, teaching strategy, techniques, etc. The statement of skill are concerned with the specific of learning. Now we look at functions of measurement. The measurement has more administrative utility in education than evaluation. An evaluation process is useful in modifying and improving learning system and instructional procedure. The measurement is precise than evaluation. Hence, it is mostly used in measuring the learning outcome. Measurement is a process of quantification. It means precision and quantification of phenomenon or variable. Now we look at functions of measurement. There are three main functions of measurement: prognosis, diagnosis, and research. Prognosis function. The first of these function is that of prognosis function. Any test tells about some differences among pupils' performance at this moment. All decisions involve prediction. Then psychological tests is mentioned. So-called IQ test administered to a student in a school to predict their academic performance come to mind. The measurement provides the extent of variable which has the specific purpose of predicting future behavior. The prognosis has the administrative function such as classification, selection, promotion, and gradation of a student. Second is diagnosis function. The prognosis function reveals the level of a student with regard to certain characteristics, whereas the diagnosis function identifies the weaknesses of student learning. The remedial instruction can be prepared on the basis of diagnosis. Third is research function. The use of measurement for research purpose, however, is not as great as for prediction and diagnosis. There is a good reason for this, as measurement is usually considered as completely valid measure of certain human characteristics. In fact, the quantification is generally considered essential for the progress of education, particularly at more advanced level. The scales of measurement have also been discussed here. Number one is nominal scale. The nominal scale is least precise and crude among the four basic scales of measurement. It simply implies the classification of an item into two or more categories without any extent or magnitude. The frequency of numbers are used to give a name to something that may be used for determining percent mode. For example, boys and girls, pass and fail, rural and urban. Second is ordinal scale. The ordinal scale is precise than nominal scale. It allows the teacher to assign values by placing or arranging the observation in relative rank order. Such as first rank, second rank, third rank. No value is assigned to the distance between position of ranking. The scale assigns observation to categories by number and arranges them in logical order. Third is equal interval scale. The equal interval scale is more precise and refined scale than nominal and ordinal scale. The 0 point and the unit of measurement used on the scale are arbitrary or assumed. A linear relationship is established in the equal interval scale. The equal interval scale has the greater use in teaching learning situation, educational administration, educational guidance, and counseling and educational research. The effectiveness of any instructional procedure can be evaluated precisely by collecting the data on this scale. The measurement in education is usually done on equal interval scale. The dependable references are drawn in educational research by collecting evidences on equal interval scale. Fourth is ratio scale. The ratio scale is the most refined among the four basic scales. It has all the characteristics of equal interval scale. In addition to that, it has an absolute 0 point representing complete absence of the property being measured. The ratio scale may be used for measuring the psychomotor objectives. Thanks and have a nice day.